Wanda, is there something special about today?
Well, I know the apron is a bit much, dear, but I am doing my best to blend in.
No, no, there on the calendar, someone's drawn a little heart right above today's day.
Oh, yes, the heart. Well, don't tell me you have forgotten, Viz.
Forgotten? Oh, Wanda, I'm incapable of forgetfulness. I remember everything. That's not an exaggeration. In fact, I'm incapable of exaggeration.
Well, then tell me what's so important about today's date.
What's the question?
So looking forward to it.
As have I. Today, we are celebrating.
You bet we are. It's the first time we have ever celebrated this occasion before.
It's a special day.
Perhaps an evening.
Great significance.
To us both.
Naturally.
Vision resident.
Wanda, darling.
Vision, sweetheart.
A pinch of paprika. A pinch.
Is that paprikash?
I thought it might lift your spirits.
Spirits lifted.
In my defense, I haven't actually ever eaten anything before, so...
Okay.
Wanda?
Hmm.
No one dislikes you, Wanda.
Thanks.
Oh, you're welcome. No, it's an involuntary response in their amygdala. They can't help but be.
Are you?
I make the rules and patterns.
I used to think of myself one way, but after this, I am something else. I'm still me, I think. But that's not what everyone else sees.
Do you know, I don't know what this is. Not really. I know it's not of this world. The powered Loki staff gave you your abilities, but its true nature is a mystery. And yet it is part of it.
Are you afraid of it?
I wish to understand it. The more I do, the less it controls me. One day, who knows, I may even control it.
I don't know what's in this.
hospitality. Guess who?
Oh, is that my host behind me?
It certainly is.
Who are those people?
What are you wearing?
Why are they here?
It's so romantic to do the candles, the music, that stunning outfit.
Dinner is served.
Let's have a toast to my lovely and talented wife.
To our esteemed guest.
Yes, chin chin.
Cheers. Well, please eat before it gets cold.
Mrs. Hart, allow me.
So, where did you two move from? What brought you here? How long have you been married, and why don't you have children?
I think what my wife means to say is that we moved from.
Yes, we moved from.
And we were married.
Yes, we were married.
Well. Move from where? Married when?
No, patience, Arthur. They're setting up their story. Let them tell it.
We. Our story.
Thank you. I don't need food. What I mean to say is that I don't need food in between meals, but in meal times. Regular intermissions.
Thank you.
Would you look at the time?
Better be going.
Are you both all right?
We had such a lovely time.
Yeah, thank you for coming.
Tonight, son. First thing Monday morning, you and me are gonna have a little chat. We'll see about that promotion, huh?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
This guest is leaving your home.
Or a song. Or even wedding rings.
Well, we could probably do that. Today could be our anniversary.
Of what? Surviving our first dinner party?
Precisely. And our song could be?
Yeah, naturally.
Naturally.
And the rings?
Well, could you make some for us? I do. Do you?
Yes, I do.
And then the happy in the world.
Morning, Devil.
Morning.
How are you feeling, Tony? He's a lucky devil. You wouldn't want to sit this one out, would you?
I know.
My baby. Everything checks out, General.
Good.
Melissa asked me to give her a love. She wanted to come and see you off herself. I don't break regulations, not even for my own daughter.
No, sir, I understand.
Sonny, this is your week. I'm open today and marry Melissa on Sunday.
We'll throw you a bachelor party when you get back.
All systems A-okay. 10 seconds to firing. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Liftoff.
Final stage misfired. He won't be able to maintain orbit.
Control the Stardust 1. Control the Stardust 1. Come in, Tony.
Stardust 1, control. Get out of there.
Final stage rocket misfired. We're going to have to bring you back. Stand by.
This is General Stone. We have an emergency. Stardust 1 is coming down. Alert the 7th Fleet.
Bandiye gush bifarmone tuem sarvar.
Sorry, Cotton.
No, it was funny.
Yes, it was very funny, wasn't it?
You know, I suppose if I hadn't come along, you'd still be in this. Wait a minute. I rescued you.
I rescued. That means I get a free wish or something. Genies do that, don't they? Well, of course they do. Yeah, Genie, I tell you what, I wish. I wish there was a big, beautiful P2V right up in the sky over my head, right now.
Dorom ketuam sarvari.
I have to get a genie who doesn't speak English. Airplane. Airplane, you know. It's up in the sky, up there, see?
See more.
Oh, yes. All right, say more. No. Ginny, take it away.
Timur.
Yeah, that was a Samur, all right.
Sarvar ayar hotoretoro, azor de amaro bebash.
All right, look, forget about the airplane. I wish for a ship, Ginny. A boat. In the water, in the ocean. Like this. A ship.
Ah, kishti.
Yes, kishti. You're older than you look. No, it's not right, Ginny. It's not right. Take it away. Ginny, I wish you could speak English.
Your Shaw Hey Parian. Somehow I must find a way to please thee, master.
Forget it. You'll never be able to please me as long as you don't understand. You spoke English. That's all I had to do was say I wish.
Thou may ask anything of thy slave, master.
That's very kind of you. I actually don't need anything at the moment. Yes, I do. I need a helicopter.
Helicopter?
Yes, a helicopter. It's like an airplane, and it's big, and it's noisy, and, it has blades on top. Make that kind of a noise. Yeah, that's a helicopter. That's a helicopter! Genie! You're far! I don't know how to think!
I will teach thee, master!
That's wonderful of you, Genie, but I gotta get my gear. Come on, let's go! Oh, boy, wait till I get you back in the bay!
Oh, I'll travel anywhere with thee, master!
Sure! I'll wait till General Stone sees you! Genie, I'll never be able to explain you. Well, I'm setting you free.
Oh, thou hast set me free, master. Now I belong to thee.
No. You don't understand that. I rescued you, and you rescued me. We're even. I'm going home now, and you go wherever you go, okay? Goodbye, Jenny. Goodbye.
Myself, where am I?
Well, I'm not quite sure. The storm blew us off course.
Well, how'd you find it?
Instinct, Captain. Instinct. Come on, let's go get your gear.
Yeah, can't wait to get out of here.
Did you lose something?
No, it's all right.
You say something? Did you say anything?
No. Come on, let's go.
Fascinated by these local courtship customers.
Hello, Dr. Bellows.
Melissa, would you excuse us while your fiancé and I have a chat?
I'll wait for you outside. I'll drive you home.
Wonderful.
Doctor?
Well, I've just checked over your report. You don't seem to have suffered any physical after effects.
No, sir.
No emotional after effects?
Not exactly. No, it was nothing really. I sort of had a hallucination.
Did you?
Yes.
I've been floating around up there. And I suppose I was dizzy, and that in combination with the black boxes and worry and wishful thinking. She seemed very real to me at the time. Now, of course, I know now that my subconscious knew I was off the beaten track. I might never be found. When I saw that bottle on the beach, I hallucinated a genie out.
A genie?
Yes. Oh, a girl genie.
A girl genie?
Yes.
What was this genie doing?
Well, just your average, everyday, run-of-the-mill genie.
Of course. Beautiful?
Yeah.
Desirable?
Helpful.
Yes,
exactly. That's the classic fantasy. A beautiful girl on a desert island. A girl who would do anything for you.
You know who that girl was?
No, sir. I've never seen her before in my life.
She was your mother.
My mother's a Salt Lake citizen.
I'm a psychiatrist. I know a mother when I see one. Now, I suggest you go home and get some rest.
A lot of it.
Thank you, sir.
I feel a lot better getting this off my chest. For a while there, I was afraid I was cracking up.
Were you?
Goodbye.
Get me General Stone.
Darling, how would you like me to fix dinner for you?
Oh, that'd be one.
Well, the least I can do for the conquering hero.
Some hero. I didn't even finish the mission.
Oh, well, that really wasn't your fault. Is there someone in your shower?
No, of course not. Wouldn't be taking a shower. Goodbye.
Goodbye?
I didn't realize how tired I was.
Well, you're a little tired. All right, darling. I guess I understand.
I tell you what, after I get a little rest, I'll pick you up and we'll go to dinner. Well, look who's here.
I'm looking.
Melissa, this is Gina.
Tony? I've always prided myself on being tolerant, but... would you explain to me, what is that girl doing here?
That's the explanation. She's not here.
What?
She is here, but of course, she's not a girl.
Goodbye, Tony.
No, you don't understand.
Oh, I'm afraid I do understand. Tony, I may be tolerant, but that's a girl. It's a girl. What was that one doing here, Master?
That one was my fiancée.
Thou art kidding.
Now, just a minute, young lady. Melissa happens to be a very...
black-haired demon.
Oh, well, yeah. Look who's talking.
I can do much more for thee than she can.
Now, stop that, Ginny. You don't do that in America. I mean, when you're engaged to General Stone's daughter, you don't do that in America. Yes? Hello. Oh, hi, Eddie. General Stone's on his way over here. Right, thanks. General Stone's on his way. General Stone's on his way. You've got to get out of here right now, and I mean it.
Oh, I'm happy here with thee.
But you... Jeannie, I hate to do this, but I wish you to vanish. where'd I go wrong?
Thou hast set me free. That means that I'm free to please thee, and I'm going to please thee very much.
Oh, no, please. Look, you don't understand. General Stone's gonna be here any minute.
I tell you, please get back in your bottle. Okay, back in your bottle, huh?
Oh, thou art so masterful.
Now, Ginny, stop that. I mean it. Would you please cut that out? I don't think you understand how really important this is. I want you to get back in there. Now, come on. Stop playing around. Please.
Ginny, look.
Look, Ginny, look. Isn't that pretty? Look.
Ooh.
See?
glass pearl.
Yes, yes, it's yours. It's yours. Here.
I got you. Ow! Oh.
Bellows told us about your hallucination.
Oh, well, you didn't have to mention that, sir. Nothing, really. It was just the heat of the excitement.
It was nothing at all. I explained it all to him.
Sometimes these hallucinations recur, Captain. In all conscience, I can't qualify you for active duty again until we're certain that you're completely normal.
Well, I am normal. Absolutely normal. But there's no girl in the bottle.
Dr. Bellows and I both think...
Must have sneaked past.
Gee, are you all right? Now, come on, speak.
What's with this guy, Charlie?
I told you, there's a girl in there. She's in a bottle.
Well, no wonder we didn't see it. You're sick.
Yeah. Hey, don't speak. You can kill her. I'll buy the garbage from you.
What?
I'll buy the whole truck from
you. Charge for garbage.
Oh, we're in a high-class neighborhood. I mean, we got a good grade of garbage.
Give me $10. Gee, quickly, please. Gee. Oh, here she is.
Here she is. Come along with us, Captain. We'll buy you all the garbage you want.
No.
Jeannie, you can come out now. She saved my life. Well, come on out, Jeannie. The general's waiting. Look. See? Now, come on.
Yeah, now I see her. She's really quite smooth.
She's beautiful.
Very clear. You and this girl. Inside of this bottle playing marbles.
In the hall of hospital. Please, wait, sir. Please.
You really believed me, didn't you? I really had you fooled.
Oh, if you could see the expression on your face.
What do you mean you had us fooled?
Well, I was putting you on. Do you remember the time you locked me in the freezing chamber and left me there, huh? Do you remember the time you blew me out of the wind tunnel?
Well, I was just getting back at
you. You mean the whole thing is just a gag?
What a gag? I really had you guys going.
You made it seem remarkably real. Very interesting.
Well, I certainly hope I didn't carry this too far, General.
You really had me worried, Tony. I wouldn't want a son-in-law who went around seeing genies, would I?
Oh, well, of course not, sir. You get some rest. I'll see you in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Hi, how about you guys? I really
believe you. We thought we lost you. You know,
practically,
you're
showing me the future.
Thou deceived me. I should turn thee into a serpent with two heads.
No, don't do anything you're going to feel sorry for.
I trusted thee. What manner of master art thou?
I appreciate everything you've done for me. Honestly, I do. But there's just no room for you in my life.
I wish you'd take my shirt off, Gene.
No, I mean, I wish you'd put on your own clothes. You're just not Air Force, Gene.
I have a career. I have a fiancé.
That one. She's made of ice. She could never make thee happy. For over 2,000 years, I've been in that bottle. And then this hand released me. When I saw thy wise face, I cannot tell thee how much happiness thou hast brought to me.
No.
Thomas, be
nice. Wait, now stop. Can you put me down? Ginny, stop.
Now, is this not better?
Well,
he's going into orbit.
How'd you get in that crazy bottle anyway?
Oh, a wicked and powerful djinn put me in there because I would not marry him.
You poor kid. It must have been wild in those days.
Oh, it was. It would please me to see it.
Hey, this is oil. Ladies, no. Please, stop. We don't do this in Cocoa Beach. Look, Jeannie, would you please, would you take this up? Would you stop this?
I shall not please, Master.
Yes. No. No. Look, they're about to lock me up now.
Oh! Thou art the most stubborn and ungrateful master I've ever served.
Hey, Jeannie, where's the glass? That's very, very kind of you. You can go. Disappear. Jeannie, don't leave me here. Well, don't leave them here.
I want us to part friends.
I'll tell you what. Let's go get your bottle and take it down to the beach.
Or somewhere where you can swim and you need to take off. I'm sorry, I hurt your feelings.
So that's what's been going on since I've been out of town, huh?
I never saw him before in my life.
But he's got a bottle waiting for you over at his place. You rock a homebreaker, do you?
No. Sir, I wasn't talking to your wife, sir. I was talking to your smoke. I thought it was a friend of mine.
Hello, Tony.
We were having a little barbecue, sir.
Are you going to a costume ball?
No. Well, I thought I might. Shall we go inside? Why don't we stay out here, sir? It's so cool.
Oh, Tony, look where we started.
Well, you won't like it in there.
Oh, I'm not.
Well, for one thing, I'm redecorating.
And you didn't tell me?
Wait! I can explain everything. It's very simple.
Oh, that's much better.
Tony, there are certain things that are expected of Melissa's husband.
Yes, sir, I know.
Find that amusing?
No. Funny.
What did you say?
Oh, nothing.
You seem very nervous, though.
I'm fine.
I'm going to recommend a vacation for you.
That's an excellent idea, sir. Somewhere a long, long way away from here.
That's a wonderful idea. I believe in long honeymoons.
So do I.
I know that you've been under a terrible strain, darling. And I'm willing to make allowances. Up to a point. But you don't want me to make allowances?
Oh, I do. Get out of that dress.
What?
I didn't mean you, Melissa.
Tony, when you were up there, you didn't meet any unidentified flying objects, did you?
Tony's just tired. After all, he has been through a lot.
You'll never know, Melissa.
I think you're going to feel so much better once we get married.
Did you get out of here?
What?
Not you, sir.
All right, darling. I think it's time that you should go to bed.
I think you're absolutely right.
I'll come by and see you in the morning.
I think it might be a better idea if I came by to see you.
Naturally, I don't want to find that girl around here anymore.
Good night. Good night, Dad. In general.
I'm going to see that everything is just fine, darling. Oh, just fine.
Fine. Good night. Good night. Oh.
Laugh.
You're laughing. I'm dying. I'm glad you're enjoying yourself because the party's over.
I am a grown man, and I will not let someone taking over my life like this. Do you understand that? I won't.
Jeannie, what are you doing? I'm sorry, Jeannie. You have got to go. I want you to get on your magic carpet or however you travel. When I get up in the morning, I don't want to see you here. You understand that?
Thank you.